because even though it's a counter matchup, it's almost like a soft counter because it's honestly more on the jungle skirmishing. If Beyond ganks for the lane, then
it was like a 3-hour RPG.
It was a work, but he also has expression.
Well, it was a pretty good one. Expression though, gonna get jumped on. The Sun will come through. He gets jumped, and one last smack from the Trundle will take him down. So remember what we were talking about, Garbage or Majestic? I think we're starting to lean towards the former a little bit here for Expression.
Really, there is a path in this lane to victory.
I'm ready for the Proto Belt. Let me see it. You can also see it on the Gragas. We're talking about
a lot of damage.
Monty, but yeah, Max getting engaged on the Ignite Tick. He'll take one more shot, but heal used by Maha will help keep him alive. But some really good early.
Sure. Some really impressive performances. Looking for a wraparound around bot side. Remember, Fury Flash in front of Beyond.
Yeah, well, here comes Beyond. The play comes through from Max. Looks like they're going to get jumped straight onto Fury. Gets the concussive blows with the knockup out of the end. Bro, he sees it now as Chaser roaming in. He'll stay safe. Body slam in here. Beyond just going to waddle his way out. Jason is still trying to
build rage here.
Yeah, he's going to try to. Throws that one out, but flashes away immediately. He does have that Gnar ultimate available. If he can just get the transformation, doesn't matter. Chaser goes in. Now here comes Expression, ready to turn into that Mega Gnar. They should be able to die if this one with relative. He's one more attack. The stun's not going to connect. Chaser's going to have to go deep.
Uh-oh.
Body slam whiffs. The barrel not going to connect. An ADD just walks his way to victory. Now Ian on the roam up, looking for Chaser. Flashes the wall. There it is. Picks up the kill, will equalize it in a 1-1, but wow, what a botched dive by Longju.
Well, Rox Tigers did the same thing a couple of days ago, and apparently Longju thought anything you guys can do, we can do better, and by...
Oh, the spirit of bubbling will live on forever.
One of the most famous Oceanic League of Legends clips, in fact, is... as we see Max down bot lane.
Yeah, Max going aggressive. Here comes Beyond over the wall. We'll get the pop-up on the Pure straight to the concussive blows. The heal comes out, but the Ignite's there to match. Maha with one last auto attack will take him down, but here comes the curtain call. Max is going to go ahead, throws out the Glacial Fissure. Nicely done. We'll interrupt that one. And they are going to find another kill. And now the BF sword completed from Maha. Fury still a ways away, and ADD is just not afraid. He's going aggressive. Meanwhile, the bot side, speaking of aggressive, the box coming down. Maha taking a bunch of damage to the cast. He's going to get spell shielded out, but the barrel is able to finish him off with TP now being completed by Ian as he arrives. They will find a kill onto Pure, but the curtain call's there. They're firing shots into Ian.
Special
takes a bunch of damage.
Mega-Gnar.
Nice wall, trying to keep Expression away, but they're right next to that one. They could lock him down. Fury comes in with the W, takes out two, finding the double kill onto ADD and Beyond. Nicely played by Longju. Good execution. They come out on top.
Even though MVP channeled both their teleports first, Coco had ghosted to bot to be there. Maha died first, so Beyond was waiting for the counter gank. Had to wait too long, was baited in, and Maha died. So it ends up being a big one trade by Longju.
And has netted himself a little bit of a lead. It's going to be the Void Rush here. Straight into a box from Beyond. Tunnels out immediately. Juicer's there with the body, so I'm going to follow up. Max not in a position to really try to protect him. Hook comes through on the Maha. Beyond going to tunnel over, get himself out of that curtain call. He's going to retreat up that bottom at that. Just a couple more pushes from Ian in that mid-side. We'll be able to take down the tower. We can see Coco just trying to clear that
That's
out as best
as pretty confident.
Yeah. Chaser, though, coming in over the wall. Is going to get the slow out with the barrel. Stuns immediately from Ian. Wall comes through, but it doesn't matter. Flayed in. The egg's going to get popped, and he's going to go down. Nice little turnaround here from Longju. They will find themselves with a kill lead. Gold lead not quite going to be there yet, but it's going to be damn close.
That was either a next-level play from Coco or very fortuitous timing. He used his pull to wave clear the
minion. I think all four will connect. Minions, of course, dying in the mid-side will allow him to sustain back up, but he's still just about 55% with the dragon start up. Looks like Longju will be able to claim this for themselves. Second dragon taken away. Beyond goes in way too late, putting Smite. Throws down the chilling onto Chaser, but still cannot find the play, and he's just going to void rush out to the other side of the wall.
Yeah, the percentage play for MVP here is to push mid lane. They have a very low outer turret. This will open up some really good options for them. Yep, they're going to chunk it out.
Yep. Trying to get on this one, the turn will go down. Meanwhile, AP's been completely segregated on the other side. The box comes down, slowing him up. He has to flash. The W will not connect, throws down the pillar, and that should be enough to disengage MVP. So they lose the Ocean Drake.
Five-man Hema play, if MVP opt into a five-man fight, they have opportunities to disengage, but very much going to be grouped as five.
Oh boy. Max going up here, will get grabbed up straight to the curtain call. Chaser's there, trying to capitalize. Glacial Fissure gets thrown out, and they're trying to get on to Pure, who goes over the wall, flash away by Chaser as well. This could be a fight for MVP. Ian comes through, is not able to get
auto
the flash
attacks.
Freeze yet, finally finds it, takes him down. That's going to be a kill picked up here for MVP. Now going on to Fury, ADD going to go ahead, pop the subjugate. But they can't pursue any further, so despite getting caught out.
Ian can teleport down, but Anivia wants setup time. Very much a control mage right to Vladimir, so teleport plays are difficult. We're going to see the teleport.
This might work. Beyond goes in. It's going to be taken away by Chaser, who's able to find that one. Big cast comes through, knocking MVP into the wall. Now Expansion pitching it from back. Has that Narvar build up to half. Looks like MVP are just going to turn around, trying to get onto him. It's going to be the Probelt used in ADD all by his lonesome up in the front of the fight. Expansion gets locked up by the Anivia. Looks like he barely might make it out of this one. He does, but he does help pick up a kill on the side of ADD. So with the top laner is going to be falling down. Now with the curtain call pop, going to be finding a kill onto Max. Can they find more? Wall comes out from Ian, will stop them from getting a hook in. But overall, it's a 2-for-1 pickup for Longju, plus a second Ocean Drake.
They are at the moment cheating towards mid lane and Baron. It's probably not Baron time for Longju, but certainly going to be the mid lane outer turret. It was a nice Gnar ultimate, but no.
It's already been on it. It gets chunked down to half, but be able to make that up very quickly with the transfusion. Beyond starting to roam back up, walks over that trap from the Djinn.
They don't know what health it's at, now they do.
Yeah, this Baron's already down below half. Wall comes through from Ian, keeping Chaser stuck into the pit. Takes the Lantern out, Max up in the front line. Glacial Pitch comes through, does find Pierre. Beyond goes in, gets the pop-up in, onto the Thresh. They will be able to burn him out. Ian finds the kill, but the cast comes through, and Beyond gets knocked right into the back line of Longju. They take him out with relative ease. Now the curtain call pop. The shot's coming through, trying to find Max. ADD will eat the last one as he takes down Coco. It's a 2-for-1 so far from MVP. They stop the Baron, so they definitely come out on top of this one. ADD is going to be taking a little bit of damage off the backside of this pick.
His power level is directly proportional to the strength of the enemy tank line, and Trundle and Rek'Sai are very powerful at this point. Yep. Speaking of power plays, MVP's going for one of their own.
Yeah, they TP this one in. Longju coming nearby to try to check this out. They will spot them. There should be MVP backing off, especially as that teleport comes in from Expression. Doesn't have anything on the Narvar. ADD gets grabbed up by that hook. Will be pulled into the box, and Longju just trying to pinch in from the top of that Gnar. Curtain call is going to be opened up. Max takes the first shot, the second one as well. Half the body block, the rest of these, or he will go down. Big chunk off of Ian. And that might be Longju sticking around to try to take out this Baron. Everybody on their side, really healthy.
Really optimistic start by MP. They don't have a fast Baron. They now open up Longju to go for a Baron of their own. They've cleared out Vision. Baron's coming down. It's at 7,000.
Expression is going to be transforming into that Meganar. A big frontline beyond on the backside of the pit. Might be looking to go in for the steal.
He's in Vision, so Longju have full information.
Starting to regen. Just big chunk out onto Fury from Ian. That's going to be the boomerang going forward. Not going to find the connection. Expression, Gnar ulting him back, but they're still sticking on top of him. He has to flash over the wall. Now Coco might be the target. Big shield comes out from the Seraph's Embrace from Ian, trying to get through that Hemoplague, but it drops a little bit too soon. It gets chunked out, and MVP are really going to have to back off this one. The question is, does Longju back off, or do they stick around?
Seems like MVP are the ones that are going to clear out Vision. Baron is re-aggroed. Beyond's going to back, has the ability to Rek'Sai ult. Anivia can also teleport in, so MVP could go for the Reforce, and Longju will have less teleports to get back in.
Looks like they might be doing that, trying to get onto Coco, who goes straight into the segment pool. We'll take that Lantern out to safety. Expression now going to be the one targeted out. Uses the hop, doesn't have the flash, gets knocked up. Guardian Angel looks like it might be going down. One last jump, they will be able to pop that one. Coco getting chunked out, almost gets stunned up by the concussive blows. He's going to try to get out of this one. Expression might just be the sacrificial Yordle. He will go down. Ian finds the kill, and AD not done yet. Has that GLA of his own. Says, you know what, I can stick around in the front lines, but 50% increase from that Elder Dragon.
Still less Ocean Drake than Longju, it's worth noting.
But still in a very good spot. So at that point, Longju, you're more likely to roam back to the fountain. See the curtain call, though, going to be opened up on the Ian. Gets hooked in. Can they confirm the kill? The egg is there to keep alive. The Hemoplague comes down, and it looks like he might not be getting out of this one alive. He does not. Djinn finding the first kill. Beyond chunked out as well. Has to tunnel away, and ADD barely going to miss getting rooted by that W from the Djinn. Expansion still hot on the chase. The boomerang comes through, does slow up Beyond, and did a significant amount of damage. It's about 10% of the Anivia's HP, and now we can see with that pick, a massive amount of waves are gone. Longju are starting to push up into this mid lane, trying to get some picks. ADD going to pop the subjugate. Moving forward, regenning a lot of HP. Can they find a pick? Teleport's almost available for Ian if they can find a flank ward and make a massive play. It's getting ready to come up now. Longju retreating down through the river. Big ward in the bottom lane with the pink. He might be able to make a move for that one. ADD trying to get on to Pure. Go for it. They get the knockup. Pure's going to go down. ADD jumping him out. Still playing up in that front line. The pillar down. Fury getting really slowed up. And now the TP channeling from that Anivia has the flank. Here comes Chaser. Walls him off. Keeps him contained next to the rest of MVP. He does body slam over. Looks like they might not be able to get any more kills. Just going to be the Thresh going down, but this could open them to take out this first inhibitor tower in the bottom side.
They're a little bit slow on pulling the trigger on the teleport play. They're going to tank up this inhibitor turret and take it, though, so still going to get a big objective from this. The minion wave being proxied by Chaser doesn't matter when you have a super tank Trundle and Rek'Sai frontline. They take the inhibitor, but there could be some exit kills here for Longzhu.
Well, they use the curtain call, but they're going to go ahead and cancel that one out. Fury just looking for the refund on the cooldown. Beyond getting rooted as it goes through, we'll be able to tunnel off to safety. Running now in 12 seconds, MVP certainly want to get ready for that with vision control.
Yeah, full build Anivia versus full build Vladimir. This does feel like one of those another eerie scenarios where it's hard to see how Coco will really get value out of the AoE from the Vladimir. Trundle Pillar, they outlined them in the champion select, but the Anivia also is Maha's hook.
Yeah, gets a hook air into the Sivir, gets bursted out. Wow, Pure just blowing up. Meanwhile, MVP was taking the Baron, and now ADD really far forward, just going to lose that Guardian Angel. He's going to go down. This could be a Baron, but for Longzhu.
It's going to be a free Baron, no way to contest this. Ult started, they don't actually have... You see what I'm saying?
Yeah. A couple times, Chaser though in a really bad spot, the wall comes through, they just lock him up. GA will get popped. And they finalize the kill. He used the cask, so no way to disengage. Looks like the Grog is just going to go down. Nicely played. And a good pickup there from MVP. Now we'll be able to clear out this wave in the top side. Keep that team.
Like such is the fact that we're 53 minutes in. A single pick from a teleport, from a misposition, will decide the game.
Well, you said a single pick. Uh-oh. ADD roaming up into this brush. Does not see all of Longzhu waiting for him around the corner. He gets chunked out, throws out the subjugate, but there's just nothing that he can do. Fury. Now it's all going to be about tiptoeing around this objective. As you mentioned, pretty much the team that nets this should win the game. Ward comes over the wall from the side of Longzhu, especially trying to build that Narbar as best as he can, but I don't think he has enough time. He has to get there ASAP. This thing's being burned down. He hasn't even channeled the TP. They're going to go ahead, surrender this one over. Now teleporting in, has it to about 60% of the Narbar. Glacial Pitcher comes out, pops up Coco, takes a bunch of damage, throws down that Hemo Plague. Expression comes in. Can he get the transform? Gets his GA pop before he can cast the ultimate. MVP need to really position now. Only finds Beyond into the wall. He's hopping away, trying to get to safety. Coco using that Proto Belt to try and create more distance, but MVP are really chasing. The pillar comes down, locks two members out of that path. They come forward. They find Expression and Pure, but a big stun comes through from the Gnar. Doesn't matter. Ian is able to fire back. Take out the Thresh. Pillar not going to cut him off this time. Beyond goes over the wall with the tunnel. Can he find a pop-up? Doesn't look like it. Expression will be able to jump his way back to safety, but MVP coming out with a pick, knocking down the GA, and now possibly a second inhibitor in the mid.
Yeah, the extra options they had through the Sivir ultimate meant they could get a fight. In fact, they had the Sivir ultimate up again, such as its short cooldown. Only Thresh is down. This is risky. 5v4 against both of the Nexus turrets for Longzhu.
Lots of Baron-empowered minions in here. The wall comes through onto Coco, takes a huge chunk of damage as he goes into the Sanguine Pool. Looks like Chaser might be the first one that falls. This GA does get popped. Expression hopping to the other side of the Nexus, trying to keep himself alive. Coco regenning with the transfusion, but it doesn't matter. There's so much power, so many minions, and MVP off of a free Baron from Longzhu take out game one.
Longzhu didn't really feel like they juggled their tools effectively. No.